everyone. Welcome back to the other 167. I'm Carol and I bring you warm greetings in Jesus' name. Today we have Dr. Nyaneshwar Solkar, who is an evangelist, preacher and a teacher in Mumbai. And he is going to teach us about the importance of proclaiming the Christ's death. So without any further ado, let's tune into it.
Dear people of God, Shalom. This is Dr. Nyaneshwar Solkar on your favorite devotional channel, The Other 167. Welcome to the second session on Journey to the Cross. On Palm Sunday, we heard and understood how important it is to know our Lord personally. Today on this Maundy Thursday, we are going to contemplate on a topic: Death of Christ, Remembrance and Proclamation. Let us turn to the scripture, this time to the 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 to 32. Probably this is the first account about the Lord's Supper before the Gospels were written. The Gospels help us to understand the history, but this passage specially written by Paul help us how to do it and why to do it. Friends, let me invite you today to join with a meal with Jesus. Those who joined the meal, their life was transformed. And probably as we hear and partake in this meal, I'm sure we'll have a changed life. I just want to ask probably one question. What will be your response to the death of Christ? Probably crying, weeping? Friends, that's not what the Lord expects from us. He told to the women who were crying, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me." Then what he is expecting from us is very clearly mentioned in this passage. We should remember and proclaim his death. Just before we go and try to understand, just understand few things which are here. On the verse 23, Paul writes, "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you." This clearly mentions what Paul is writing here. It's not a fairy tale, an imaginary thing. It's a fact he received from the Lord himself. Then in the verse 23, it's also said, on the night he was betrayed. Why there should be a mention of betrayal, specifying that night? Because Jesus wanted to tell us, even today his own disciple must have betrayed him, but his response was kind, a sacrifice, his broken body and poured blood. How long we should do it? Till he comes. And it should be said whenever. It's not a Sunday affair. This should be done every day. And Jesus here tell twice to do it. Do this. What does it mean? It's not an option. This is not an option. This is a command from our Lord. And our Lord will never tell us to do something without purpose. How can we ignore it also? He said, remember. What does this word mean? A passive thinking? No. Just imaginary memory? No. Understanding the history? No. The basic word here, it means in the Greek, the action, the partaking, the action. This is not a remembrance, this is a celebration. That's why the upper room was decorated. And Jesus himself prepared for this celebration. Who prepares for his own death? Who celebrates his own death? That's why Christian faith is unique, because there is a purpose behind this. His death was not curse. His death was really a blessing to us. Redeem us from the sin. Deliver us from that bondage. He always wants us to proclaim it. It's not a private affair to do it within the four walls. The death of Christ, the cross of Christ has to be proclaimed. Christian faith is not a private limited company. We'll have to proclaim it, friends. But before that, we got to learn how to partake in this communion, Lord's Supper. Jesus not only said, do this, he also explains how to do it. It is not the simple physical things he is talking about. How to take it, whether standing, kneeling, with shoes or without shoes, with single cup or multiple cups. No. Because this is have a spiritual significance, not physical, it's a spiritual. Ye andar ki baat hai. And there are two elements which are very symbolic here. The bread and wine. Very ordinary things of those days. Even today. But both are very symbolic. The bread suggests and indicates the body. And the wine, the red color itself, indicate the blood. And bread and wine, before they get into this form, they have to be crushed. Jesus was crushed for us. And for the body, for the life, we need a body and blood together. You can't have the blood in the one cup and say, this is life. No. You can't have the body without blood and say, it's life. No. There has to be a body, and then the body, there has to be a blood. That becomes life. Jesus gave us life by breaking his body and pouring his blood. He broke it. These elements are not mementos. This has to be eaten and drank. You have to drink it. It's not a memorial service he has been invited. Because he is not dead. He is alive. You can't have the memorial service for the person who is alive. Then how to take it? It's a serious thing. Here it says, we got to self-examine ourselves. Ask for the forgiveness of our sins. You can't come casually and drink the cup and eat the bread. You have to judge yourself. Find out within ourselves, instead of judging others, find out what is wrong in me. You can't come in front of the partake in the Lord's table unless you self-examine and judge yourself. And recognize why you are doing this. Recognize the body of Christ, and also is the body of Christ that is church. And this has to be done together. It's said unitedly it has to be done. It's not a private thing to do it in the home. You have to do it together. And if that's called the worthy manners. If you don't do it worthily, don't judge ourselves, don't self-introspect, don't ask for the forgiveness, there will be consequences of taking the communion. Communion will not take you to the heaven, friends. If it's not taken in this proper way, what God wants us to do it. He said the consequences are you'll be guilty. If you don't self-examine, you don't come there without forgiving your own friends, you will be held guilty. And he will bring judgment on you. What a serious warning. You will be sick. You will be weak. And the worst warning will be you will die. How can somebody believe that after taking a communion, people can die? Yes. We will die if we don't take it in a right way. That's what this message is. That's what this passage is. That's what this exhortation from the Lord directly through Paul. It's so important spiritually. It is not just the symbols. It has to be realized how relevant this is. Friends, I invite you to join this meal today with Jesus. How will come? Very basic things. You clean your hands, clean yourself and come. How will come? Must have an appetite for the meal. How you will come? Don't eat junk and come. You know what I mean what by junk. How will come? Come unitedly. Remain in harmony. Will enjoy the meal. And while going, thank Lord for the meal. What a wonderful meal it is. Jesus, we should proclaim it to the world. What we got. Invite them to be a partakers in this by asking for forgiveness and accepting Jesus and his death. Thank you, friend, for listening. God bless.
We partake in communion because Jesus commands us to do so. And if we love him, we will keep the commandments. If you're new here and you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Share it with your friends and family members. Also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. You could also write to us on the email mentioned on the screen. God bless you.